bring it on soundstage.
What's Cargo? It's Cargo Soundstage.
Cargo is a club night in Sheffield.
Ah, so where's that?
It's basically the bedroom in Sheffield. We run on Tuesday nights, giving DJs a chance to play.
Oh, you're a professional DJ? Yeah, paid for it.
No, semi-pro. I've been more than a...
So do you do a regular night down there?
Just like what James just mentioned it. Yeah. Been playing at bedroom, but it's moving to DQ now in Sheffield. Every Tuesday nights, every Thursday. He'll play at.
Here on a Wednesday. We're going to be doing the Earl soon every Friday. Well,
oh, I know the Earl. I know. Yeah. It's just got a new owner, isn't it?
Yeah. So we're going to be doing the upstairs.
Have you travelled far to come here?
No.
You live on the estate?
No, abroad.
What?
Down near Walter Bridge.
Alright, so have you seen things change around here then? Or do you know people around here?
Yeah, my nan lives across,
So it's good all the... have they started a new youth?
Well, we're from the Hillsborough Liberal Democrats. I'm Steve Harris, and we're putting up a stall selling strawberries and cream.
Alright.
So, hope that the weather's going to stay bright and that people come along and buy the strawberries.
My hands are graded from she ran at A2 for a long time.
Did she win much? Did she win a few?
Oh, she won a few, yeah. She won about 29 races, and she came a close second in a lot of those as well.
Does it look like whippets? No. Hi, you're obviously here from Ski Village.
Yes, we are.
Some people are going to do some skiing today?
We're not skiing, we've got some sledges for the kids to try today.
Alright, it's down this... what do you call it?
Mobile slope.
Mobile. Do you know, what do you think of the changes around the area, around here? Do you know the Winn Gardens Estate much?
I know of it, yes, but we don't come down here very often, so...
Oh, you just come down for the day?
Just come down for the day.
Are there any other cars expected today, do you think?
Not that I know of, no. I saw it on the web, on the internet, and I just emailed the person in charge and said, I've got a car, do you want me to bring it down?
Sheffield Wildlife Trust. We brought along our display today of the West End Waterways project, which is it's a project that's been running for a couple of months now. Based on the River Don, from Deep Car to Stooge Bridge.
Yeah, to about here. Maybe.
To about here. We just sort of collected the ecological data to see what's there, and then hopefully we'll be using some community work days to improve the area a little bit. Well, some of the invasive species are the Japanese knotweed. This is unfortunately a real big problem along the River Don. This is Himalayan balsam. Again, that's another big problem. So, and giant hogweed. These are the species that we sort of know if we see them, so that we can try and get some management to try and cut down on that there. Some of the other species we've got are the bluebells, the carpets of bluebells, which are absolutely beautiful around about April or May. They're really gorgeous.
Do you have a website or anything that people can keep in touch with what you're doing?
We have. That'll be on one of here. We've got these membership leaflets as well if people like to join. Yes, it's got the www.wildsheffield.com.
They can find out what they think about Hillsborough. Yeah. Does it meet their needs? You know what I mean? And, you know, we've had issues going around the festivals, just things like, you know, there's enough trendy shops, there's enough sports shops and stuff, and we're kind of feeding that back in because that's the issue. But yes, I mean, Hillsborough is part of like two bigger regeneration areas, so there's so much of Southern Ulton regeneration.
Yeah, that's the one I was thinking.
And there's Northwest Strategy Group.
Right.
And we fit in both camps. We're kind of in the middle.
Last Wednesday, with Winners, myself and Gemma Darby, who runs the nursery there, organised a litter pick on the estate. And we had 28 young kids between 5 and 11. Ooh. Came out voluntarily. We went out, we collected over 35 bags of rubbish.
Yeah.
On the estate.
Okay. Can you tell us a bit about what you're making?
Well, I'm making a totem pole to go by the gate of the park, based on children playing. So it's going to be based on snakes and ladders. And it's going to have some figures climbing the ladders, sliding down the snakes. A pair of guys at the top.
Do you know how long it'll take to make that?
What, a piece of wood?
Yeah.
Probably about 13 feet.
How difficult is it doing that without making a mistake or something? You can't really get a bigger razor about what you did, can you?
No, you just have to change your design if you make a big mistake. But just take it in little stages and hopefully we're not making any mistakes.
We go around the
And what are you going to do next round?
Okay, we're going to do a few street and disco freestyle routines for you today.
Is that like what you'd do if you were going out dancing, or is it like a fitness thing?
It's more like what you see on the top of the Pops.
That's right.
Everything's different
at the moment. So is it a course that you're on, or you're a team, you're a professional
group?
Okay,
we're a dance group, yeah. We're a dance group.
And how have you been formed by?
Okay, we've been set up for the last 2 years. Okay, in our local community. We also put on workshops as well.
Right. At school?
At school.
And do you enjoy doing that then?
Pardon?
Do you enjoy doing that?
Yeah, I do. It's brilliant.
Right. What do you lot do then? You're a part of the group.
Yeah.
So how do you when you're doing this refreshing and all that, seeing all people, you know, getting together and all that, helping out.
We were commenting about the fact that how many people have turned out, and, you know, it's really well organised.
Okay. What's been your highlight for today?
Seeing the gospel choir, I thought they were very good.
My name's Elise.
My name's Rob.
So what, have you done anything to help here today? Do you do anything to help? Is your mums and dads here, or your family here?
No, we just
used to. And you live over in Winn Gardens?
Yes.
But do you use the new pavilion?
Yes.
Is that good?
Yes.
Tell me about it, what do you do?
Well, sometimes you can,
so you get to eat and cook and do things like that. Oh, that's great.
You like our company car?
I like it.
Someone's told me that they've made a new park over in Middlewood, just over there for young people. Have you been involved in that?
No, not really.
What do you think of the new youth shelter? Do you use that? Is that good for young people? So people come and chill then?
Looks it like them being a deaf people.
Sure. Well, I'll sit here then. Well, it's fantastic. It gives you a chance to sort of get out and about and meet some wonderful people in some wonderful sort of setting like that. I mean, the Lord Mayor's son is getting married, which is the reason why she's not getting the award personally. I know that she's wishing to send her best wishes, because when the communities can get together like this, it's absolutely fantastic. We're delighted that Winn Gardens is able to itself now put on a show like this. Tremendous credit for the festival really, because I spent so long at home.
Gives encouragement, and if people can use it afterwards, it gives a bit of encouragement for getting things together for next year as well.
We've kind of captured the sort of flavour of the day, so we've been around, we were here from the beginning of the day when everybody was setting up.
You mean the hassle? Setting up?
Yeah, all the setting up and things.
All the stress.
It was a bit damp earlier on, but it's looking like it's
Well, yeah, I worry that if it lashes it down with rain, nobody turns up and all that.
But I mean, as a project, we were involved with Winn Gardens when they were setting up the pavilion.
Yes, about as far back as you. Yeah. They're as old as us.
I've just come back after a couple of years, so it's really good to see it's actually happening.
Lovely. It's really smashing.
And we're going to pop into the pavilion later and have a look.
Good. They're doing a smashing job. Questions. Good luck to both of you people.
Thanks.
Can our budding young reporter ask you?
Yes, of course.
Yeah. Shall we get the reporter?
Tell me where the eye line is going to be, as they say in the trade. So I'm looking into the camera.
I've got nothing, so there ain't one.
No, go on with you.
You're looking into the camera now.
Okay. Fire away.
It's a question, a simple question.
What do you think happens with community, though, when they get all together and do this sort of good spirited things like this?
I think this is a marvellous example of how people who are willing to stick with it. Well, at least the first two or three years were dreadful. I mean, people just thought nothing was going to happen. They didn't think it was going to work. People got disheartened. But a group of people who were instrumental in keeping the community going stuck with it. And it's worked. And people can see today just how wonderful it is that people have come together, they've worked together, they've made the community not just so much better, but literally back into a community. And it's entirely due to all these wonderful ladies who have insisted that I wear a pink jumper in order to be in line with them, and I'm proud to do that.
It was nothing to do with us. Okay, shall we...
Is that all right for you?
Go and have a wonder.
Very good, thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
And then now he's
Chris Caitlin, who's our music man.
Good to see you.
I think that's all.
Certainly will.
Who's taking this?
My guys from KMP were helping.
Right, very good.
You're alright, it's not a storm.
So the people are saying, are you watching it?
Hi Simon, how are you with me? It's all right. Nice to see you. How do you want at barbers?
Well, apart from the fact that she cut me an edge.
Yeah,
people from Middlewood Winners that's worked hard in this area. So I mean like to have vision to organise something like today and other improvements such as nursery and lots of other stuff going off on the state. They've done a really good job and it's fantastic what they've achieved. Certainly.
What are you doing here today?
We're from local Labour Party, Brightside and Hillsborough Labour Party. We've just got a stall with lots of information on today, letting people know what we've been up to, our MPs and councillors and European MPs. We've got a few books and videos to sell off. It's a fundraising, trying to...
We'll be right back.
Yeah, we're filming it. Can you tell us a little bit about your project?
Right, what is with Wheelie Bingo Club? We run every Wednesday night with Wheelie Bingo, Big Wheelie Club, up locals from along. And what it is today, we're trying to raise money for the community. For kids have a Christmas party, and we'll put, like, for next year we will be doing an estate trip for them. So we've got like tombola, raffle, melons, guess the name of the teddy, guess how many sweets, and all money's going towards the community. But
We're the Sheffield Stop Smoking Service, and we provide a fantastic service for anyone who wants to stop smoking. Unfortunately, we've not seen that many today, but hey, free phone numbers available for everybody.
Have you gone out to have a look around today? Have you enjoyed most of that today?
Oh, it's been good.
That's
just me.
Meeting people.
Yeah.
Let's go. Thank you. All right, let's go.